What up, YouTube? This your motherfucking Saying Crazy Brain back another video. Yes, we're back in this bitch. So we about to do a different type of video today. Now, I was going to put this on my Saying Crazy Gaming channel, but I think I'm going to put it on a main channel because this ain't really game related. It's more movie related. So, yeah, I saw a lot of people on YouTube do these little things where they rank their favorite, you know, Marvel movies, Star Wars movies, Star Trek movies, you know, from best to worst. And I'm going to do one with Star Wars, you know, because why not? Like, it's one of my favorite franchises out there, you know, besides Marvel and Star Trek. And obviously, you know, because, I mean, I'm a total nerd when it comes to that shit. Like, not gonna lie. I'm a total nerd. So, yeah, I'm going to nerd out a little bit on this video, but it is what it is. I'm going to go through my favorite Star Wars movie to my worst, or my least favorite, you know. So, my first one. Now, this one can be debatable, but this is just my opinion, so, yeah, it is what it is. So, if you disagree with it, that's on you. But, yeah, this is my opinion. So, me personally, this is one of my favorites. Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker. Now, I'm going to tell you why. So, yeah, not to give any too much spoilers for people that have not watched the previous one, which is, I think, Last Jedi. Was it Last Jedi? I don't know. It was one of them. Let me see. I got a whole stack of them right here. So, yeah, I think it was. Yeah, the Last Jedi. But yeah, not to spoil Last Jedi, but yeah, it does. This movie right here, Rise Skywalker, does fix a lot of fucking plot holes. You know, obviously every Star Wars movie's gonna have a plot hole on it, you know. That's just how they fucking make them. I don't know why. That's why they have different TV shows and spin-offs, you know. But it is what it is. To kind of fill those plot holes. But, you know, it is what it is. But this one is my favorite mainly because it fixes a lot of what the last movie didn't really, you know. The last movie, like, the one before that they made, before they made this one, The Last Jedi, they didn't really, to be honest, they didn't really do a terrific job with it, you know, the way they set it up and everything. But yeah, this kind of fixes that and kind of redeems, you know, what Star Wars is all about. You know, that's mainly why I like it. You know, you get Emperor Palpatine, they bring him back on there just to kill him off again, but it is what it is. Like I said, it's very debatable. Some people hate it, some people like it, but me personally, it's one of my favorites though, because, you know, like I said, it kind of goes back to the original trilogy kind of fucking setup, you know, but it is what it is. Alright, so that's one of my favorites. Now, let's see, my next one. let's do this one. Force Awakens. This is another one of my favorites. Now, the reason why I like this one mainly is because, you know, Han Solo's in it. Yeah. Not just because Han Solo's in it, but it's really, like, it kind of introduces you to, like, the next trilogy, kind of. Like, all the new characters, they have a really good setup on it, and it's kind of, you know, it kind of reminds me of Attack of the Clones, the way they kind of set everything up and kind of do all that, you know. But yeah, anyway, I like it though. It's a pretty good movie. A lot of people are debating on it because, you know, obviously Han Solo gets fucking killed off, you know, but teach their own. But this is just my opinion. All right, my next favorite have to be Return of the Jedi. Classic. This one is definitely a classic, you know, like it or hate it. I definitely like what they did with the Ewoks, you know, and the Force of Endor and all that shit, you know. They didn't really go too much in the Ewoks. I think they did. They had an Ewoks movie that came out, you know, after they got done doing the whole trilogy. Actually, literally after they got done doing this movie, They did another one about the Ewoks, but that's for another video. But definitely good setup. Palpatine's on here as well, Emperor Palpatine. Apparently he dies on this one, but yet they resurrect him on, you know, the the Rise of Skywalker, but it is what it is. I mean, like I said, this is just my opinion, but everybody has their own. But yeah, that is number three. Let's see. Number four. I've got to go with Attack of the Clones. Like, the way they set it up, like, this movie is phenomenal. Like, when I first saw this movie, I was stunned about it, you know? Like, it's got a lot of good characters on it. It also delves into, you know, Anakin's turn to the dark side and kind of, you know, shows that on there, you know, after, you know, his mom dies and whatnot. And, you know, you get the whole gist of it. I'm pretty sure by this point everybody's seen this movie, but if you're not, sorry if I spoiled it for you, but it is what it is. Like I said, I'm a complete nerd when it comes to the fucking Star Wars shit, but yeah, I gotta put this at number four, you know. And I'm doing this, you know, 1 through 9. 1 being the best, 9 being the worst. So I'm kind of just doing it that way, because there's nine of these movies, and I'm not counting the spin-offs or the TV shows or anything like that. I'm just doing the whole, you know, Skywalker saga. Basically, that's what this shit is, you know, because it revolves around Skywalker and his whole family, you know, but it is what it is. My next favorite movie, gotta be Revenge of the Sith. Yep, have to put this one after Attack of the Clones, mainly because, you know, I mean, the beginning is kind of, I mean, it, I do like the beginning because, you know, I like the saber scene with you know, Count Dooku and Obi-Wan and how they fight at the beginning, you know. But then, like, kind of mid end, like not in the middle of the movie, but like, you know, a quarter into the movie, it kind of does get a little bit boring, you know, because, you know, it's just a little bit of dialogue, but it is what it is. But yeah, it definitely gets more interesting the more you watch it. Like, dude, like, if you get past the I kind of feel on this one they kind of added a little bit of dialogue to kind of, you know, fill the time slot for the movie theater when it came out, but it is what it is. But yeah, after you get past that long dialogue at the beginning, this movie gets way better from there. Like, you know, with you know, Obi-Wan battling General Grievous to, you know, Anakin falling to the dark side, you know, kind of, this film kind of takes off from what this one, you know, left you off with, almost. But, you know, to each their own. But yeah, definitely I gotta put this at number 5. So yeah, I mean, I like it, you know, it's just kind of half and half for me, you know. But it is what it is. All right, next one, Empire Strikes Back, another classic. I kind of like this one, you know. I mean, you know, it's got a lot of good scenes in it. It's pretty good. It takes off from what New Hope does leave off with, you know. With, you know, the Battle of Hoth, I like the battle scene on there. And then, you know, with Han Solo being frozen in carbonite, and, you know, C-3PO getting blown up, I think that was hilarious. But yeah, this is definitely a classic. It's one of my favorites. Another one of my favorites, you know. But yeah, this one's going at number 6, because the next one I'm about to put, dude, next one I'm about to put up, like I said, I'm doing this shit with movies that, the movies I like. So this is just all my opinion. So if you don't like it, it's on you. But yeah, I gotta put this at number 6. But yeah, Empire Strikes Back. And plus, I like how they, you know, did Yoda on here. Like, dude, the way they introduced Yoda was hilarious on here. Like, if you've not watched it, you gotta watch that shit. This ain't the droids you're looking for. See, I'm already nerding out. But yeah, anyway, next movie, I gotta go with New Hope. It's a fucking classic. Definitely sets up Luke's story. It sets up Leia's story. But you don't really kind of get, like, too much detail on her, because, you know, she gets captured, obviously, and then they have to go fucking rescue her on the fucking Death Star and shit. But yeah, this is definitely a classic. Not because it's the first fucking Star Wars movie they made. But yeah, I just like it because it sets everything up, you know, for the next franchises that come out after that came out after that. So definitely it's a staple, you know. I've got to put that at, let's see, I think that's number, yeah, that's number 7. All right, so now we're going to get to these next two films. These next two films were not the greatest, to be honest, in my opinion. And I'm gonna give you all why. I'm gonna have to put this one at number 8. The Phantom Menace. I mean it has a pretty good story to it, but I was not a fan of Jar Jar Binks. I think he was kind of, you know, a filling character. He was like, you know how some movies have those filling characters where, you know, they're not really used for much and they're just like in there and out of there for like 2 seconds and that's it. You know, I don't like it when movies do that. I really don't. But that's kind of why I didn't like this movie. I kind of think Jar Jar was, you know, an unnecessary thing to happen for the Star Wars universe. But for whatever reason, George Lucas put, you know, Jar Jar Binks in there. It is what it is. Definitely, besides that, it's got a pretty good storyline. You kind of get introduced to Anakin as a kid, you know. He does the pod races and everything. I wasn't too much of a fan of the pod races, but, you know, it is what it is. Especially with the video games as well, you know. Because I suck at racing games, to be honest. Like Need for Speed, fucking all that shit. That's why you don't see me playing too much racing games on my YouTube channel, because I fucking suck at them, but it is what it is. But yeah, definitely Phantom Menace. It did introduce one character I did like, and it's the Sith character. It's Darth Maul. I definitely did not like how they killed him off on this movie. They definitely killed off fucking Qui-Gon Jinn. He's another Jedi on here. I personally wanted to learn a little bit more about Qui-Gon Jinn. They just kind of, I feel like they kind of threw these characters in, and they're like, okay, we're just gonna go ahead and throw these characters in, but we're gonna fucking kill them off before we introduce them and their fucking backstory to y'all. That's kind of how I felt about this movie, you know. So that's why I'm putting this, you know, towards the very bottom, because, you know, they could have done way better with, you know, presenting some of the characters on here. But, you know, they kind of squandered it, but it is what it is. It's already been done. It's already been done made, you know. Yeah, which leads me to this next one. The Last Jedi. If there was not a train wreck of fucking Star Wars movies, this takes the fucking cake. Like, this makes the fucking Phantom Menace movie look fucking golden. And I already told y'all why I didn't like the Phantom Menace movie. Dude, they introduced a new character on this movie. I wasn't really personally a fan of it, you know. They introduced Rose on there, which I didn't really, you know, get why they did that, you know. They definitely butchered Luke's character on here, definitely. Everybody said that, and I didn't really know that until I went back and rewatched these movies from start to end, and definitely they did, because everything Luke stood for in the previous saga fucking threw that shit out the window of this movie, which that's why I put, you know, which one did I put at the beginning? Hold on, let me look. Yeah, that's where I put the Rise of Skywalker at the beginning, because that one kind of redeems all the characters, like, with Leia, with Han, with, you know, Luke, fucking, yeah, because, fucking, this movie completely butchered all them. I didn't really like that. I don't like it when franchises do that shit, when they butcher your favorite fucking characters that are the major fucking characters in the whole fucking saga, and they just fucking decide, oh, we're just gonna butcher them off. We're just gonna give Luke a fucking grumpy old man fucking persona. That's kind of how they gave him on here, you know. Like, he was just a grumpy old man living on a fucking island with, like, you know, isolated from everybody, you know. And whenever Rey was trying to train or whatever, he just fucking walk off like nothing at all, like an angry fucking grandpa. That's kind of how they fucking push it off as, you know. It was definitely funny in the movie theaters when I went to see it, but now that I rewatched it again, fucking yeah, this was a train wreck of a movie. And plus, dude, they could have done more with it. They could have maybe had Rey and fucking Kylo Ren team up or some shit, but for whatever reason they didn't want to. They're like, nope, we're not gonna have them team up. We're just gonna have them, try to, you know, fight over a lightsaber. Like, dude, definitely a train wreck of a movie. And then plus fucking, Princess Leia, she fucking drags her fucking self onto the fucking ship. I thought that was corny as shit. Yeah, a lot of corny scenes on here. Which that's why it kind of makes it a train wreck, you know. They basically squandered what they could. They squandered a lot of shit in making this movie. They could have made it way better. But it is what it is, you know. These mistakes have already been done. So yeah, that's my opinion on it. If you guys like my opinion on it, let me know. If you guys don't agree with it, like I said, that's on you. These are just my opinions, you know. So yeah, let me go ahead and go through this again. So, number 1, Rise of Skywalker. Number 2, Force Awakens. Number 3, Return of the Jedi. Number 4, Attack of the Clones. Number 5, Revenge of the Sith. Number 6, Empire Strikes Back. Number 7, New Hope. Number 8, The Phantom Menace. And then number 9, Last Jedi. So yeah, that's my ranking of it. If you guys enjoyed it, go ahead and leave a like down below. But yeah, that's my opinion. Those are my favorites. So yeah, comment down below which Star Wars movie is your favorite and what they could have done better with them, because obviously each one of these movies does have their fucking plot holes and their flaws, you know. But it is what it is. If you guys have any ideas on what they could have done better, or just, you know, in general with like the characters and everything, let me know. But yeah, anyway, hope you all enjoyed this video. This is your motherfucking Saint Christ signing out, and I will see y'all in the next video.